Okay, so with the Montreal Canadiens and their exposed list at the expansion draft, there have been so many concerns brought up by other NHL teams that I thought it would actually be appropriate to make a video about this stuff. Now, in particular, we're going to be focusing on two guys here, Weber and Price. If you want the entire scoop, we had made a video yesterday talking about how the Habs could lose, potentially, all of these guys, Weber, Price, Tatar, Drouin, and Deneau, over the course of an offseason, which is absolutely mind-blowing to me personally. But, as we noted, Weber, Price, these two guys being exposed on the Seattle list, have indeed raised some concerns. Thank you to those in yesterday's video who commented Sycamoose BC. If you want a chance to be featured in the next video, then stick around to the end of this one. But we're going over what Elliot Friedman said a few times on different mediums out there on social media. Firstly, we're going to go over onto what he said on the 31 Thoughts podcast. This is what Blaine Potvin tweeted out from the Hockey Writers, talking about what it was that Friedman said about Shea Weber and the potential injuries that he is facing, and how that works out with the salary cap, the Seattle expansion, etc. Friedman reported on his podcast that some teams in the NHL think that the Weber injury is utter BS to get around the expansion draft, and that the NHL will be very strict about what happened. Blaine then gives his own opinion. Number one, it's Shea Weber. Number two, multiple injuries are plausible. Number three, it is Shea Weber. Now, what exactly does this tweet mean? What does it mean that other teams are saying that the Weber injury is utter BS? By the way, utter BS, completely different from what Nikita Kucherov says. Number one BS is what he talked about over there. But either or, the main idea that is being explained here is actually gone over in greater detail when Elliot Friedman published this article yesterday. Carey Price's uncertain injury status complicates the Kraken's decision. We're going to be talking about Carey Price in a little bit here, but we're just going to finish our thought here on Shea Weber first. If you scroll down in this Elliot Friedman article, it says that we may not get any clarity on Shea Weber until training camp medicals. The league will see what doctors determine then. There was some interesting feedback on his situation from other teams in the league. No one questioned his integrity or his injuries themselves, but they don't like the timing because of the expansion draft and the fact that he played so well in the postseason, as only Victor Hedman and Ben Chiarot played more minutes. Another NHL general manager said that he felt Nashville should not face a cap penalty if Shea Weber retired, because the Predators didn't actually sign Weber to that contract themselves, they matched an offer sheet, which is why they have that contract in place. So, what this is saying, pretty much, is, okay, teams aren't going out there and talking about Shea Weber like, oh, the guy's just pretending to be injured. This is Nikita Kucherov number two. Okay, that was kind of a joke there. It's not like teams are believing that Shea Weber isn't really hurt. They're just questioning the timing about it. Okay, you have a guy who is already hurt at the exact moment the expansion draft lists are going to be revealed and locked in, meaning that you can expose Shea Weber to Seattle, and they're not going to take him because he's hurt? Really? You're going to reveal all this stuff now? And to that I say, you know what, that's just Marc Bergevin going out there and doing what it is a general manager is going to do. People have been posting, like, the puppets on a string meme all over social media the past few days about Marc Bergevin treating the NHL media like puppets because he's just going out there and doing what it is that he wants to do. And because of the nature of this situation here, where Shea Weber's injury is publicized right before the expansion draft, making it a lot more likely that Seattle just goes, okay, we're not going to take Weber, like, come on, the guy's out, he may not even play again, why take him? It's gotten to a point now where it's like, I don't think the NHL is going to do anything about this, you know? Some other teams, other GMs may believe that the NHL will be strict here, but based off how the NHL handled the Nikita Kucherov situation, I don't really know if anything's going to go down. Furthermore, we have ourselves a bigger discussion here on Carey Price. This is what Pierre LeBrun tweeted out yesterday. For what it's worth, for those pondering the idea of Seattle selecting Carey Price only to trade him back to Montreal, the Habs throwing picks and assets at Seattle for the Kraken to retain salary, etc., the NHL has informed both teams that that is a total no-go. The league considers that clear cap circumvention. So, There's one possibility completely taken off the table here. Seattle cannot select Carey Price and then trade Carey Price back to Montreal with salary retained because the NHL doesn't like that. Furthermore, Pierre LeBrun also said this week that he is told Carey Price is scheduled to see a doctor in New York regarding a knee issue which could also potentially lead to surgery. The hope here is that it's not too serious. As Frank Saravelli reported as well, Pierre LeBrun believes Carey Price will have his hip checked out too, but the potential surgery that he has been told is knee-related. Then he also said one more, "It's a hefty contract to be sure, but I'm told the Kraken are taking a deep dive internally on whether or not to take Carey Price in the expansion draft. My guess is they don't, but at the end of the day, I do think there's a better chance of it than I first thought." Intriguing. A lot of this has to do with Carey Price and the injuries. As we noted, he is potentially going to go out there, have himself a surgery, all this other checking up with his knee and his hip and all that too, which is why we get further into the idea that Marc Bergevin is just playing the puppeteer at this point. Let's go back over to Elliot Friedman's article talking about Carey Price's uncertain injury and how it complicates the Kraken's decision. Sunday night, approximately 24 hours after the news got out that Price was unprotected, reports surfaced that he could need surgery to his hips and or knees. As a couple of sources indicated, the goaltender is dealing with multiple issues that need clarity, and it is possible that he could be out heading into the 21-22 season. The facts are right here. It is absolutely impossible for Seattle to not seriously consider Carey Price. There are extremely legitimate on- and off-ice reasons to select Price. He could be Seattle's closer and the Marc-Andre Fleury standard bearer for the franchise. He played junior hockey in the state, and his wife is from Washington. Word is, they're seriously considering it, but it gets a little bit tricky after that. The Kraken have to submit their picks by Wednesday morning, to be revealed that night. And the catch is that Carey Price is not going to see his doctors until after that deadline. Because Seattle is supposed to get a full medical picture of all the exposed players, this isn't really going over all too well. Other teams are boiling, complaining that the Canadiens are using Price and Weber to make a mockery of the expansion process. Frank Saravelli also said in a report that Price may miss significant time next season with a hip injury. And if that's the case, then Seattle has no choice but to look at Carey Price and be like, man, this guy's great, but he costs $10.5 million a season. Honestly, if he was healthy, if he was here, we'd be willing to bite the bullet, but if we just don't know, why would we take the risk when other goalies like Bishop, like Jonathan Quick, like Holtby are available too? This is where things get a little bit more kind of laughable if you're a Canadiens fan, because it starts to boil down more with what the Seattle Kraken might have been asking from the Habs and Marc Bergevin in order for them to not take a goalie. The article on Sportsnet written by Friedman talks about how Merrick says he heard the Kraken were asking for a first and a third as payment for not taking anyone left unprotected. The cost was steep, and Bergevin didn't want to pay that to preserve Jake Allen, and despite considering trading Allen last week, his heart wasn't really into it. And so now you go out there and you do this little maneuver right here. Expose Carey Price, leak out to the media, oh, he's got hip stuff, he's got knee stuff, he might require surgery, he might not play next year. You have Shea Weber who has similar issues over there too, maybe LTIR, who knows. You have yourselves an opportunity here to really just stick it to the Seattle Kraken and say, man, you guys are asking for way too much. We've got our own tricks up our sleeves right here. We're going to reveal this information at the exact right time to make it the most inconvenient for you into maybe screwing up and taking the wrong guy on draft day. In fact, take a look at this. This is from the Daily Faceoff article. Sources indicate it was actually Price's idea himself to waive his no-move clause, knowing the uncertainty of his health. The belief is that he did not want to see the Kraken select Allen while he was potentially unavailable to start the season, thus leaving the Habs in a tough spot to fill the void without both of their netminders. Eventually, stuff went down. The NHL actually allowed the Canadiens to leave Price exposed because it was actually Price himself who wanted to get that wave. So, big ups, not just to Bergevin, but to Price too. And who knows? If Carey Price has his reports and the medical stuff done in New York, let's say a week from now, and it's revealed, okay, he's fine. He is okay. He is not going to have any surgery or anything. The Kraken are going to look at that and be like, wow, are you serious? You should have done this right after the finals. Why'd you wait until the expansion draft to screw us over into making a different decision than we would have had if we'd known what happened with Carey Price? They have 3 days to get this done, or 2 days, because this video is going to be uploaded on Monday. We have 2 days for the Seattle Kraken to get their picks together and submit their list Wednesday morning. And Carey Price and Weber not having that security with their health is the biggest thing right here. And it's why other GMs are being really upset right now in this whole Carey Price and Weber thing. And honestly, I said it before, I'll say it again. It's Bergevin doing what Bergevin does, taking the rule set, crumpling it up into a ball, and tossing it aside in the most legal way possible. So, talk to me in the comments what you think about Mark Bergevin, Price, Weber, the controversy here with the Seattle Kraken. If you made it to the end of this video, then hey, comment in the comment section below, Tri-City Americans, because Carey Price played his junior hockey with the Tri-City Americans in Washington State for a chance to be featured in the next Canadiens video. But I hope you enjoyed this video over here. So that's Rolls Lion 9, and bye.